नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू दिस स्पेशल एपिसोड ऑफ रियर विंडो. आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू गिव दिस एपिसोड एन एपिसोड नंबर बिकॉज इट्स एन आउट ऑफ लाइन एपिसोड इन अ वे, बट आई हैड टू डू दिस टुडे बिकॉज टुडे इज द बर्थ एनिवर्सरी ऑफ माई फेवरेट सिंगर ऑफ ऑल टाइम्स, द लेजेंडरी किशोर कुमार. There is a lot one could talk about Kishore Kumar, his songs, his music, his acting, even his lyric writing and his movies. And I propose to do this eventually on Rear Window, where we can, you know, talk about individual songs of Kishore Kumar and see the magic unfold about those songs. But that is not the purpose of today's podcast. Unfortunately, I could never meet Kishore Kumar in person, and perhaps I was born a little late for that. Although I remember that, you know, I don't remember having cried at any deaths or funerals, but on the 13th October 1987, just 10 days after I had turned 16, I cried a lot because Kishore Kumar passed away that day. And I remember I went to the elevator of my building and I cried because I didn't want to show, you know, that I was crying and I was upset. Perhaps we are too imprisoned by the adages like boys don't cry and at that time. Anyway, that's a phase of the past. Today, I want to share with you an exclusive moment that I shared not with the man, but with his music. I never had the good fortune to meet him, as I said, but I did share an exclusive moment with one of his songs. And now that song is not talked about much, even among music lovers, I think. But I find it to be one of his very special renditions. It so happened that the veteran director, Sai Paranspe, she was hunting for a chawl, a typical Mumbai chawl, for her film Katha. And at that time, I think the film was called Kachua or Khargosh because it was an adaptation of a play by Shango Sathe called Sasa Ani Kasav. They probably changed the name later for ease of pronunciation from Kachwa to or Khargosh to Katha. Now the film, you know, starred Farooq Sheikh, Nasruddin Shah, the beautiful Deepthi Naval. But Sai Paranspe could not find a typical Mumbai chawl in Mumbai, and she found it in Pune. Now, as luck would have it, the chawl that she finalized happened to be the residence of my maternal grandparents, my grandfather Shankar Rao Biniwale, about whom I tweeted just day before yesterday, and there was a rousing applause for that tweet. He was a well-known violinist, and my mother, Lalakari, who actually incidentally had played in a program on Akashwani as when she was a child. She too played the violin, and she played in a Akashwani program called Bal Darbar, which was compared by Sai Paranspe. So she sort of knew my mother and my grandfather. So the shoot of Katha was like a festival for all the residents of the Salunkewada, where this film was shot. The usually sleepy chawl had come to life with the hustle bustle of the shooting and the arrival of film stars and camera. On their part, even the film stars behaved like an extended family of the residents of Salunkhewada. I had a long holiday in school, and during all long holidays, I used to visit my maternal grandparents. And this was no exception this time. There was little more excitement because the child was in such a gay mood. And the first star that I saw was Deepthi Naval. Dark and beautiful. I remember she was very quiet and dignified in the way she carried herself. Farooq Sheikh, on the other hand, was very pally with all the local residents. And when I went to him for an autograph, he signed my autograph book with a smile and asked me in Marathi about which school I went to. When I told him I was from Mumbai, he said in Marathi, "Are wa, mi sudha Mumbai saski." So every time I watch Katha, it takes me back in time. There are so many signs of the past in that film that nostalgia grips me every time. The scene where Leela Mishra gives a thalipit, a traditional dish, Maharashtrian dish made with multiple flowers. She gives it to Farooq Sheikh. That scene was shot in our kitchen. And the curtains hanging in Deepthi Naval's house were made by my grandmother. They were sewn by my grandmother. And the wall hangings were made by my mother. So even my grandfather, grandparents can be seen in a couple of scenes, you know, in that film. But even today, one memory that holds sway over me is the shooting of the song Maine Tumse Kuch Nahi Manga. Okay. Music director Raj Kamal has some of the sweetest melodies to his name. You see Chashme Baddur, Savan Ko Aane Do. But this is a rare song which was sung by Kishore Kumar. I don't remember Raj Kamal Kishore Kumar combination in other films. Of course, he must have sung, but this is one of the major songs that they did together, and I think it's a fantastic combination coming together, and a rare one. So you don't even associate Sai Paran Space films with the Kishore Kumar song, and this was one of those rare occasions. You know, the shooting of the song was fixed for a night shift. So not only the unit of the film and the actors, but the entire Salunkhewada was awake to watch the shoot of this song. So when the song was played, you know, on the Nagra with Kishore Kumar's baritone voice, you know, the Nagra is a machine where they used to play back the song. And the Nagra had, it was specifically used for film shoots, because any other player, if it was a little slow or fast, then there would be a problem in the, when you married the audio to the video in a film. So they used to use this machine called Nagra to sync, because that was that played at the exact speed at which the song had been recorded. And it would become easier to marry the audio to the video. There would be no synchronization problems. I was just a child, and I was looking out of the window, you know, when this everything started, the shoot. And they played the song on the Nagra, and Kishore Kumar's deep baritone voice just filled up the entire space. Maine tumse kuch nahi maanga, maine tumse kuch nahi maanga. आज दे दो सो बरस से जगे इन नैनों को नींद का वरदान दे दो मैंने तुमसे कुछ नहीं मांगा. द मोमेंट the voice filled all the the night, the beautiful lyric by Indu Jain, very very Hindi words. Normally so many Urdu words are used in a song, but lot of Hindi words, pure Hindi words in this song, and a little different texture of words as opposed to the usual set of words that were found in Hindi film lyrics. And I think that's because of Sai Paran Spe's sense of aesthetic. She has a very different sense of aesthetic, very she has got a different feel for the language, whether it's Marathi or Hindi. You can tell that it's a Sai Paran Spe dialogue by the wit, the humor, and she has a very very good aesthetic sense even for the lyric writing. So even in Chashme Baddur songs you can tell. Now it was exquisitely sung by Kishore Kumar. The scene was such that Nasruddin Shah, another actor in the film, had to catch the hem of Deepthi Naval's sari, her pallu. And as she went up the stairs of the chawl, and then she gently pulls it out of his hand and he releases it, watching her go. Now this particular shot, I remember I was watching out of the window, and the shot went into numerous takes and retakes as the two veteran actors just could not get the timing right. Sai Paran Spe was adamant, and rightfully so, that she wanted Nasruddin Shah to release the sari on the downbeat. And the words I remember, घेरती खुशबुएं फिर वही आहटे बारहा चौंकना फिर वही करवटे वही बाहों के घेरों में बंधना वही नजरों के साए में तपना कब तलक डोर खींचेगी मुझको कब तलक डोर खींचेगी मुझको छोड़ दो मेरा अभिमान दे दो. So this छोड़ दो मेरा अभिमान दे दो, and that time छोड़ दो, at that word छोड़ दो, दीप्ति नवल pulls the sari and छोड़ दो मेरा अभिमान दे दो, at that छोड़ दो मेरा अभिमान. So at one of the downbeat, छोड़ दो मेरा. So at the छोड़ दो, Nasruddin Shah had to release that hem of Deepthi Naval sari. Now they just could not get that downbeat right, and somehow that moment eluded him every time. And he used to release the hem of the sari either too early or too late. So it was quite a number of takes before the actors and the unit, they actors got it right, and finally the unit and even the members of the Salunke Wada, they heaved a sigh of relief that finally they had got the scene right. I'll never forget that shot. That song stayed with me, a little boy looking out of his window and hearing Kishore Kumar's unreleased song again and again. I think perhaps that's the only Kishore Kumar song that I have heard before the picture came to the theaters. When I saw Katha in the theaters, I remember I was choked when this song came. And I don't know the reason, because there was no understandable reason. I think I might have just missed that moment, you know. That the past never comes back again. You know, if that moment would have gone on forever, I would have maybe kept watching. Another Kishore Kumar song, Zindagi ke safar mein guzar jate hain jo makam wo fir nahi aate. So maybe I had just missed that moment, and it brought a, you know, I choked there on that moment when the song came in the theaters. And I might have been, I think it was 1983 or 82. It was 82. So that's one song of Kishore Kumar that maybe not many people would remember on his birth anniversary, but I have a special relationship with it, and that's why I remembered it. Thanks for listening to this episode of Rear Window. We'll meet at the regular episodes on next Sunday. Bye.